Krishna from Shishya Bimal Public School, 7th grade. So now I'm going to teach you how to make an application with Code2Play. This application will help you convert the text you type into speech. This can be used in monitors, phones, and any device which you have. So come on, let's see. Now, once you're in your desktop, first open the web browser. Here I'll use the Chrome web browser. Once the web browser gets open, search for steamdesi.in. Once you search, you get a page showing this. So, you can start a blank project or get tutorials. So now, let us see how to make the Talk to Me application. So we'll start a blank project. Remember that the project name should not have spaces. So instead of space, you can use a underscore. Then you click on enter and the project gets created. And you can open on the project by double clicking on it. You get a screen like this. So for making this, we need a text box, a button and a non-visible component named text to speech. So you can get the text box from the user interface and you can also get the button from the user interface. After this, we need the text to speech component. So you can search for text to speech. So you get your text to speech component. You can drag it and drop it. You will see that it is a non-visible component. After this, you can design it also. And next we need to do the coding part of this. For this, we need to click on the blocks. Once you click on blocks, you get a screen like this. So first we need to do when the button click. So we can get that while clicking here the button 1. So when button 1 click do, we can get this. Then here we need to click on the text to speech component. Here call text to speech 1 speak message. That can be drag and drop place here under the button 1. Next we need to speak the message which is written in the text box. So we can click on the text box and click on text box 1 dot and here we can change it to anything we want. So I'll change it to text. After this, we need to design it. So I will click on screen 1 for the decoration. The alignment can be in center so that this comes in center. And we want to change this text for button 1. So click on the button over here in the components and click on rename to speak or talk. I'll rename to talk and click on enter. Again, it does not get changed. Then go down and here text for button 1 can be renamed to talk. You can see that it is renamed and you can also adjust the height, width and you can insert any image over here. And this talk button can also be changed. So here the font type. The font type is default, you can change it to the one you like. And the alignment is center, that one also can be changed. And the shape of the button. The shape of the button is default now. You can change it to any shape you like. It can be rounded or anything which you like. And the text box. The text box font size is 14. It can be in bold or it can be in italic as per your wish. And you have many options over here. Next, when you come to the screen one, you have many different options over here. For this, the name can be changed. You have many versions. After that, you can also change the background image. So here I have an empty background. If you want to change the image, you can click on here and you can upload your file. So when I click on upload file, it's given option choose file. I click on choose file option. It opens your files. You can go to pictures and click on any pictures. So if I want this picture to open, then I can click on the picture and click on the open button. And here the image is selected and you can click on OK. So within a few seconds, this gets opened here. Okay, and next about the screen, you can write something about the screen over here. To view this in monitor size or target size, you can use this. So if I click on tablet size, it gets enlarged. And if I click on monitor size, it becomes more huge. And for building the app, you have two options. One is by the QR code and another is APK file. To get the QR code, you just need to click on here and you get a QR code within few seconds. But for making the app APK file, you need to download it in your system and then transfer it to your mobile. And then it can be downloaded and the app is installed in your mobile. So here I get my QR code now and I can scan it by my mobile and it gets downloaded. Or I can download it to my device. I can click on APK save.apk to my computer. So this saves the file to my computer. You can design and make many apps like this from this software. It's very helpful to you. Thank you. Bye, Krishna.